What's good, y'all? It's Taj Rocket, okay? Mr. Highly Motivated, baby, okay? Your favorite group, X, personal trainer, man. We out here in the desert, overlooking Red Rock Canyon, here in Las Vegas, Nevada. And we about to get it in today with Functional Fitness Fridays, episode number 17. And I'm gonna have you feeling just like that today, baby. 17, y'all talking about. We gonna be feeling young and still getting it done, you know what I'm saying? But today, it's a 3-for-1 special, just like at your favorite food truck. We gonna be doing a deep squat, woo, to an inchworm, to a push-up, baby. So, what you notice, I'm focusing on that proper posture, great squat technique, and that beautiful push-up to enhance that physique, baby. Woo, I'm sweating. Oh, it's hot out here, baby, but we still gonna get that work. All right, so let me show you what we gonna do. Feet are just outside the hips. Roll the shoulders back. Flip the hips and drive that belly button into that spine the way you are designed. Now, keeping that spine aligned, keeping your chest up, core is tight, you're gonna come down into a deep squat. Wiggle your toes so your weight goes to your heels and you focus on the posterior chain of the squat. Now, come all the way down. Don't let that upper back round, so roll those shoulders, keep it pitched between your scaps. Push those elbows inside of those knees. Once you hit here, you're gonna tip from your heels to your toes. You're then gonna walk your hands out, bring your wrists directly under your shoulders, push up, walk them back, slight bend in the knees, and then stand back. Now, what I want you to do is focus on the form versus speed. So form and function instead of trying to get as many reps as possible. So once again, shoulders roll back, belly button is tucked, hip is flipped, eyes are forward, weight is in the heels. Feels like somebody's trying to push you back, but you got a strong, steady core, and you are driven into the floor. Now you're gonna come down for a deep squat. Push those elbows out in those knees. Tip from those heels to those toes. Walk those hands out. Push up, stopping that chest at elbow height. Press back up and walk lightly back. Now, if you're like, hey, I can't do regular push-ups consistently, I'm having a hard, I got you, all right? You're gonna do a regular squat to inchworm. Deep squat, inchworm. Then for the push-up portion, drop to your knees, pop back up, walk those hands back, and then back. Now, if you need to take it one step further and you have an issue with push-ups altogether, no matter how they are, just go out to a high plank or a push-up position hold, and then walk back. So you're gonna come down to that squat, walk those hands out, pause and hold, make sure those wrists are under those shoulders, eyes are about 6 to 8 inches in front of the fingertips, walk those hands back, and get used to lubricating the joints and making a whole bunch of movement, baby. That's what I'm talking about, always being a student. Now, the ultimate goal here, 10 rounds, okay? 10 rounds of each of these. Each one of these are a rep. So 10 reps or 10 rounds of those reps, however you wanna look at it. Now, if a regular push-up isn't enough, and you just need a little bit more pump in the trunk, well, not in the trunk, in the front, you know what I'm saying? I want you to come on down, walk those hands out, and add a push-up or do ascending push-ups with every rep. So that's one. Come on out. One, two, walk it back. That's two. Got some desert on my mouth. That's what I'm talking about. I'm getting face in it, baby. Face in it, you know what I'm talking about. But that what you're gonna do, you're gonna add a push-up to every rep. So you'll do 10 rounds. You'll ultimately work up to a consistent 10 push-ups. Now, once again, shoulders roll back. Keeping your spine aligned the way it was designed is very important. Look at that beautiful canyon. Our world is expanding. Don't put yourself in a box. Get out of the box and make it happen, baby. So deep squat, push those knees out. Really, weight is in those heels. When you push out against those knees, by the way, and if you do a counterbalance push with your knees against the elbows, you will feel a deep groin stretch. So not only will this be a mobility, strength, cardiovascular, if you go quick enough, and endurance exercise, but it can also be a deep stretch. Come on down, stretch it out, walk it out, knock it down. Let's say I'm on three, that's three, and then back. So, one more time, I'm gonna show you the deep squat to inchworm, head to that push-up, baby. So, deep squat, walk those hands out, push-up, walk them back, and stand. If you need an easier option number one, you're gonna come into the deep squat, walk the hands out, push up on the knees, pop back, and walk it back and stand. Easier option number two, come on down, walk them out, pause just at that top of that push up, and then hand walk it back. Now the middle one, or the one that this whole video is formulated around, deep squat to push up, and then back, and then finally, the deep squat, to inchworm, ooh, inching out, to ascending push-up. So you're gonna add a push-up to every single round that you do every time you hit the ground. Now once again, ooh, I'm snotting, I'm sneezing, the dust, oh my God, I love it. I love the earth, become one with the earth, that's what I'm talking about, baby. But your ultimate goal, do 10 total reps of this move. All right, so 10 times through. Now, this is okay to use as a warm-up or full body extravaganza. I like to do this once again with my training clients before their session. Gets their whole body moving and grooving, lubricates the joints, helps you become a little bit more mobile, less flaccid, less rigid, more noodle. And don't eat that toasted strudel, ain't good for you. Don't do it, don't do it. Pillsbury, no boy, not doughboy. No boy, no boy. Anyway, do your thing. Do it at your pace, slower, and in more control is always preferred. And do what you can. And get your work in, baby. So deep squat, inchworm, and push up. Your way to a new way, baby. I'll see you next time.